Great to have you join. In this video, we create two directories, one called custom and the other called contrib. We will learn what to place inside these directories. Here, I have my local Drupal site loaded within a code editor. This can be your editor of choice. Currently, I am using Sublime Text, but there are plenty of other editors out there, and it's a matter of personal preference. All files required for your theme project to run correctly must be placed in a single project folder. Note that this is similar to creating a custom module. This single directory needs a unique name that will identify your project, all related project files, and functions. For Drupal to discover and identify your theme, the folder needs to be placed in a themes directory. The name of your themes is important. It effectively sets the machine name for that theme. The machine name is the name Drupal refers to the theme by. Machine names can only contain letters, numbers, and underscores. The naming convention of Drupal's coding standards declare that theme names must always start with a letter. The machine name you select for a custom theme should not match the machine name of any other theme or module used on this site. When installing themes, install them in the themes directory located in the webroot directory of the Drupal project. Probably the name of your webroot is simply web, but the name of the webroot could be docroot as well. Technically, your webroot slightly varies depending upon how you installed Drupal core. If you used a composer template, such as the Drupal recommended project template, your webroot will be under the web directory. If you are hosting your site on Acquia, the name of the webroot will be docroot. For me, since I used Composer with the Drupal recommended project template, the name of my webroot is called web. The folder to place themes in is located in the webroot themes directory. For best practice, follow along and within the themes directory, create a folder called custom. Within custom, you will place any custom developed themes, like the themes we will create later on in this course. Also, within the themes directory, create a directory with the name contrib. Here is where you place any of Drupal's contributed themes inside of it. Contributed themes are those that are available from drupal.org. If you are curious to where the themes provided by Drupal core, such as Bartik or Classy, are located, let's explore them now. Within the webroot directory, there will be a directory called core. This directory is the code that powers Drupal. Never, ever modify any code contained within core. Doing so is called hacking core, and it violates a principle of Drupal development. Never hack core. Now, within the core directory, you will find another directory called themes. Do not put any custom themes here, as that is technically hacking core. If you were to update Drupal core, your custom theme would be overwritten. Always place custom themes in the custom directory we created earlier. Anyway, as you can see, the core themes of Bartik, Claro, Classy, Olivero, and more are located here. I encourage you to spend some time looking at the code and the structure of each directory. But again, remember, don't modify anything you see in the core directory. Now that we know where Drupal core themes are located, let's go back out of here and into our custom themes directory. Within webroot, themes, custom. Awesome work completing this video. I'll see you in the next one. Happy learning.